Good morning and welcome to Friday Morning Webinars, the summer edition. Today we are talking about everything you need to know about acting you can learn from David Harbour. I'm a huge David Harbour fan. David Harbour has now hit the consciousness of the public as Jim Hopper in Stranger Things, of course, in which he's fantastic and rather a genius. I was already a big fan of his because I was a newsroom junkie and he played Elliot Hirsch on the newsroom and had some incredible turns.
You mean you called it? I just told you about it.
Did you call it? No, right? Well, I don't want to get in the middle of anything, but I've always understood that you had to call it.
I did call. Okay. It's obviously every man for himself out there.
It came to my awareness during Revolutionary Road. When I saw Revolutionary Road, for the first time, he blew me away. He encapsulates a couple of concepts of acting that are the fundamentals of modern acting and what makes a master actor. And if you study his work, you will be enriched as an actor and have better tools and technique. So here we go. And Revolutionary Road is an extraordinary film. And by the way, if you're interested, there's an entire master talk in the campus. Go to the Resources Center and then go down to Master Talks. And there's a 4-hour breakdown of the entire script of Revolutionary Road by director Michael Nankin. So when I first watched Revolutionary Road in the theaters, you've got Leonardo DiCaprio and Kate Winslet. So you've got these two powerhouses and they are both extraordinary in the film, unbelievable. There's this, every single character in that film and every portrayal of the characters in that film is genius. But the role of David Harbour struck me really hard. And I remember not knowing who the actor was and rushing out to figure out who he was because I was so moved by his gentle darkness, and as an actor, by his subtle internal turmoil. I'd say one of the major definitions of acting itself is the realization. If you're looking at script analysis, the moment is a realization and then a decision upon that realization. And if the scene is major realizations, two major realizations which create the act changes, and then the minor realizations throughout the whole scene, acting really is about acting upon realizations. So the essence of great acting is the ability to realize something in the moment, despite the fact that you've already read the script and studied the script and broken down the script and know that those realizations are coming. So it's the spontaneous and surprising realization of something which you have already orchestrated and understood. And that encompasses, I think, really the entire craft of acting. The ability to analyze, intellectualize, break down, and decode the script into this is the realization that I need to have. And then the art of forgetting that realization and then actually having that realization in the moment. That is what I think differs between the master actor and an actor that looks like they're portraying or acting. David Harbour is the king of the realization. And I'm
what do you call the center? And she started bleeding. He said that she lost a lot of blood before the ambulance came in here. Now they're trying to stop her. He said a whole lot of things I didn't understand about my capillaries. He said that she's unconscious. Jesus. Okay, Frank, what do you think? The hell do I want to sit out for God's sake?
Okay, Frank, just take it easy. Take it easy. Have a cigarette.
Here comes the first big realization.
She did it to herself.
She committed suicide. Here's the realization. Can't handle it.
Let me get you some coffee.
He escapes. First realization kicks him down. The woman that he loved, that he had an affair with. He comes back. with coffee. He's going to be strong for his friend. Realization, his friend's not there. Realization, his friend is there. Now watch his realization off of DiCaprio's behavior. Beautiful, just beautiful. Look at this realization right here. Look at that. Even in the still frame, you're realizing with David Harbour at what's happening. Beautiful. The second thing I think that defines David Harbour's acting as some of the best that's out there is his internal turmoil. So if I was going to say acting in general is realization, but modern acting, really the push towards modern acting in Hollywood feature films is the push towards less external conflict and more internal conflict. When you're watching films of the 50s, 60s, 70s, the actors are very externally conflict oriented. And so were our processes of studying acting. So Strasberg and Meisner and Adler was very externally conflict oriented. In 2019, in the 21st century, a lot of it is about the nuance and the complexity of, I don't know, my own narrative and my own conflict with my own narrative and my own self-seeking, searching, and my confusion about who I am and what is my authenticity, and all these concepts that didn't really exist in the 20th century. So actors like Jake Gyllenhaal, Tom Hardy, Benedict Cumberbatch, Emma Stone, if you're watching their work, you're seeing this internal conflict. Like superheroes of the 1970s, if you watch Christopher Reeve's Superman, I mean, it's external conflict versus him, you know, it's him against the world and bad and good and bad. And like, you know, the Star Wars films and things. But if you watch the modern Marvel films, or if you watch the modern, if you're looking at The Force Awakens or Rogue One, it's actually a lot more internal conflict. Our characters are fighting themselves as much as they're fighting the external world. And David Harbour is extremely good at this simmering, repressed, internalized conflict of counterpoint, that he, inside him, there's something he's fighting, and he's got to fight himself and overcome himself before he can actually fight the good fight of whatever it is he's fighting. Stranger Things, like, that's the entire concept of the show. He's pill-popping, depressive, sarcastic, slightly bullying, checked-out cop who's lost his daughter, I think it's 7 years or 5 years prior to the beginning of the show, and daughter lost her to cancer, and he's in this self-destructive mode. And he's got to overcome his own desire to self-sabotage and give up and not care, and to then, you know, finally save the kid who's in the upside down. So the show is as much about upside down world and the dark and the demonic as it is about a man overcoming his own self-destruction in order to fulfill his mandate and the role that has been set for him, which is to be a dad, you know? So David Harbour could not have been a better choice for this part, because he always plays these characters with this simmering underneath darkness, which is counterpoint, which is, by the way, the point of Stranger Things, that you've got light and dark, you've got the above and the underneath, and that we're fighting ourselves in that all the time. Everybody has their own upside down.
Hey, I love that book. It's a nasty mutt.
Yeah, I just got off the line with O'Bannon. He said that he needs to see you at the station. It's an emergency.
What the hell are you talking about? I don't work with O'Bannon.
To O'Bannon? I meant... Okay.
A little time to realize. Realization, it's the kid. The kid is dead. Horrified by the situation, walks away. Beautiful, beautiful shot. Look at that shot. Realizes he's got to do more investigating. Now watch this. Subtle realization, working it through. That was a realization that I have to do something. Look at the turmoil. There's your turmoil. Ugh. Realization has to do it. Turmoil. Realization. I encourage you to go study David Harbour's work and anything he does. There's not a false moment in Stranger Things. I've watched episodes over and over again, and in each moment, he's deeply conflicted, overcoming his own self-sabotaging wall. He jumps over his own crap in order to go redeem himself and be the hero. And I've not seen any Hellboy clips or anything yet, but in everything he's done up until now, the hallmarks of his work are deep self-conflict, which he overcomes to redeem himself, and unbelievable subtle realizations. They're massive, and you realize it with him because he's realizing it truthfully, and then you can realize it with him. The problem with the Leonardo DiCaprio realization in that moment is that he's realizing it for you. So he's going and realizing it and showing you the realization. So you're not part of that realization. But David Harbour's realizations are always incredibly truthful, ingested with very little happening because of the realization. He is simply having a realization which allows you, the audience, to realize it with him. That is the definition of modern acting. So study your David Harbour.